Hello and welcome to episode 2 of Let's Play Civilization 6. we're gonna pick up where we last left off. What I wanted to check out was my government. Let's see here. I'm trying to go for political philosophy. Okay, good. One thing I wanted to figure out is how legacy bonuses are earned. Government. Okay, here we go. Finally, all governments have legacy bonuses based on how long that government was active within your empire. For example, past the Outcast government, you'll receive a legacy bonus of faith. This counts based on how long that government was active in your empire. You may switch your government at any time, but if you switch to a government you had adopted previously, you'll incur anarchy. Oh, okay, interesting. Anarchy lasts for 2 turns, plus 1 turn for each time you were previously in this government. Anarchy causes you to lose all your player yield level yields and government bonuses. Okay, so it tends to punish you. Switching governments punishes you more for going back to a previous government. So I think it's meant to nerf waffling strategies where you switch to one form of government and then back to another, you know, to min-max certain things, so that makes sense. But it doesn't penalize people for changing governments multiple times if they're just upgrading or going to a different one each time. That's kind of good. And the reason why I'm looking up the legacy bonuses here is the U.S. Teddy Roosevelt's ability, Founding Fathers, we earn the legacy bonuses at half the usual time. But right now, we don't have, if we go to government, chiefdom don't have anything, I think, special, I don't think. Yeah, legacy bonuses. The learned policy symbol indicates government bonuses that will come over time. Are there any learned policy symbol? Learned benefits that will stay with you. Yeah, I don't think there's anything for chiefdom. Okay, well, let's continue. Yeah, I cleared the barbarian camp up here. I was worried that there might be another one down here, but it looks like we're okay for now. I'm going to rest up this warrior and hit next turn. Okay. How am I supposed to move this guy? So he's kind of blocked on this side because there were warriors blocking my path. See if I can try to go back. I'm not used to the new movement rules because if you don't have the full amount of turns to move into a specific tile, it won't let you move at all. So your turn will sometimes end unexpectedly, even though you have movement points. Just not used to it.
Okay. It is equally important to have a happy and engaged workforce as it is to have a profitable bottom line.
Okay. Do I want to change anything right now? No, I'll keep everything the same. But I have to pick a new civic. Okay, this is boosted. Well, I wanted to do political philosophy, but I haven't met three city states, which kind of sucks. So, let me work on these cheaper ones. And I have been trying, to find them, but they're just not on this side of the map for some reason. I guess I could keep going up here. Two turns, so I'm gonna keep that guy here. Oh, there's a barbarian camp up there. Actually, this is a really good place to settle my second city because you'll get access to all these resources in an arc. Let me move my warrior up here. Did I say I really like the soundtrack from this game? It's a lot, more mellow. I think it's also era specific compared to, say, Civ 5, which did have music for each Civ, but it's one set piece music. I think this one, each Civ not only has different music, but it also has different versions of the same music depending on what era you're in. Okay. Really tempting to do that. Let's do a builder first. There is some wheat here we want to improve. Actually, oh, here comes the okay. All I want is a trader, so as soon as I have my city up, I can send it to create a road. Just have to be careful with my settler here. Don't want to be too aggressive. I'm gonna pause him here. Good work. Oh, he died. Brazil warrior, okay.
Don't reinvent the wheel. Just realign it.
Can we do here? The other thing I wanted to figure out was trade routes, because I'm not really sure which tech unlocks more trade routes, which is a little bit trade. Oh, there we go, increasing trade routes. Oh, okay. Commercial hub and harbor will increase, but it can be increased by other means as well. But it doesn't really say. So it's not tied to technology like in Civ 5, where if I research something, I'll get trade routes. One, two, three. Yeah, I can move him up one more tile here. I think the Brazilians might get mad at us though for settling too close to them. I might move him up on this tile then. Might still be too close, but it's better than nothing.
Don't underrate the value of military knowledge, but if men make war in slavish obedience to rules, they will fail.
Charleston. Monument. Yep, they didn't like it. Apologies, I'll look elsewhere in the future. Lost my scout. Where's my other scout? Stuck here. Let me move him. Oh, maybe there's an opening here. Nope. More units. Can I pass through? I wonder. Okay, we'll send it to Charleston for now. Get our
In
roads
addition
on.
To bringing riches to our civilization, this trade route will gradually develop roads between our cities. Roads allow our units to no longer be impaired by the difficult terrain through which they pass.
Let's build a water mill.
My liege, we have an envoy at our disposal. We can use the envoy to gain favor with the city-state.
Vessels large may venture more, but little boats should keep near shore. Mysticism is the mistake of an act.
Well, it would be nice if I could send my envoy to a city-state, but I haven't discovered any yet, which sucks. This is a really weird game, because my test games I found several, like, right away. Just really bad RNG, I guess, and this blocking sib here doesn't help. Okay. Let's do currency so we can build a commercial hub. Well, I'm glad to know that you don't think we're a threat to you anymore. Jeez, all these barbarian camps here is not good. Okay, got our watermill up. Let's get the builder out and then work on the granary next.
Wu fan gua ren, gua ren zhi qing, tian xia mo zhi yu kang.
I like what the, well, not like, but interesting what they're doing. They're blocking our expansion north, so.
Wealth consists not in having great possessions, but in having few wants.
The AI does know what it's doing. Let's go for astrology. Yeah, the Chinese in this game likes to build wonders. I think that's their agenda. Yeah. So the message earlier was really because we haven't built any wonders, so the AI doesn't see us as a threat to them. Him up here because this side is blocked. Oh, Brazil has founded a new religion. Okay. Can claim a great person. Euclid. Why not?
Our dedication to the ways of science has attracted a great scientist to our civilization.
I don't believe in astrology. I'm a Sagittarius, and we're skeptical.
Oh, there is the barbarian encampment there. Just gonna start moving my units, take care of it. So I need to move my great scientist to this campus district here to use it, but I'm gonna hold it for now because I'm just researching fairly inexpensive technologies right now. Yeah, let's sleep you for a bit. Okay, what do I want? Get a commercial hub going. Way too many barbarians here. And I lose the scout too, which is not good. Okay, I'm gonna promote him. Movements, retreat. Oh, come on. I don't like this UI because I'll be trying to move a unit not knowing that the unit has run out of movement points, so the game thinks I'm moving the other unit, so it just moves me without giving me a warning, which is what happened there. It's happened a few times already. Yep, lost my scout. Okay. I don't like the look of that. Oh, they want us to be their friends. Okay. Two military units there. Looks kind of... looks kind of threatening.
Your grace. We have obtained greater knowledge in the art of building statues.
Each of us is carving a stone, erecting a column, or cutting a piece of stained glass in the construction of something much bigger than ourselves.
I do like the look of the cities. You can actually see that this is a capital city because it has the capital building here. Thank you. construction.
Opportunity has arrived for a change into a new and more powerful system of government. Let us strengthen our identity and enact more policies to govern our people.
I agree.
Politics is the art of the possible, the attainable, the art of the next best.
Okay, so we can change to a more advanced form of government. I like the classical republic, although autocracy is also nice if I want to go full warmonger. Now let's go with the republic. Okay, we can have another economic slot here. Settlers. Let's do that. Well, I'll use this because whenever I find the first city, I can send in my envoy, and I'll count as two. And for a wild card, let's put to this because I want to try to get a wonder at least. Better. Got a commercial district, so the next one is the market. I also need to build probably more settlers and more units. There's a lot to build. My troops are strong? Well, I don't know. I don't want to know how weak you are then.
No hour of life is wasted that is spent in the saddle. People who cannot find time for recreation
are sooner or later to find time for illness.
Oh, here's, I can see, here's the legacy bonus, plus one. So the longer I stay in here, the higher this goes. So eventually I can get this 15% without being in the Classical Republic. Okay, so I gotta watch out, there's a barbarian here. There must be a camp down here somewhere. Incense, copper. It's a good place to form a third city, but I don't know if the Brazilians are gonna freak out or not.
With the heart, build with the mind.
Go with a scout. Still need to find some city states to befriend.
Tenho que fazer isso em benefício do progresso. É preciso combatê-lo.
Okay, the Brazilians don't like us. Did they just declare war? Yep. Okay. Is there anything I can do here? Change that to ancient walls. Oh, there's the camp right there. Yeah, we'll take it. We're about to finish our first wonder, so we should get our wonder movie.
I sprang upon the swift ship in the form of a dolphin. Pray to me as Apollo Delphinius. Also, the altar itself shall be called Delphinius and overlooked forever.
Let's see, what can we build here? Get a heavy chariot out. Send this to Charleston for now. There comes their attacking units.
The poets have been mysteriously silent on the subject of cheese.
Let's see, where do I want to go next? Let's go with that. I don't plan on attacking the Brazilians, just defending my territory, because I don't want to spend a lot of time. Well, there's a lot of places for me to expand right now, and it's much more profitable for me to do that than to get bogged down building units to attack them. I think that will be my strategy. Let's they're sieging the city, so this holy site for a second and get another chariot out. You can see here, I don't automatically get to attack like in Civ 5. I gotta build this wall here that's 8 turns away before I can do that. Let's see. I'm gonna bombard chariot. And then I'm gonna bring my heavy chariot to flank them. Okay. Heal up. These archers are insanely powerful. They're just massacring all the units. I like the aggressive barbarians. They won't just sit in your camp waiting for you to attack. They'll actually move out, leave it undefended to attack, because you know what? If you're coming for them, it might be better for them to actually attack you while your unit is half health than wait for you to heal up, which is a nice change. And I mean, there are pros and cons, but I think it's mostly a good change given what the popular strategies are for people clearing out camps. They tend to just sit and wait a lot. See, my archers actually are not doing all that well. Let me finish them off. Now I'm gonna keep this here and arrest him. Gonna move him here. Okay, good. I think we're okay defending Charleston right now.
Everything has its limit. Iron ore cannot be educated into gold.
Like this sun effect on the water, and you can actually see the waves. It's a lot stronger than effect than in Civ 5. Sorry. Now they want to pay us money to end their stupid war. Fine.
Invincibility lies in the defense. The possibility.
Not really even sure what I'm aiming for right now in terms of the civics. Just kind of playing through this blind. See here, I'm just gonna finish the scout. Let's do that. And I'm gonna build another builder to improve some of this. This guy will build another trade route and a settler. There we go. Got our scout. Got that. Let's go to the granary. One turn on the holy site. Okay. Oh, got another great scientist. Triggers Eureka moments for two random technologies. Why not? Let me move him. And I'm gonna use him. Boosted guilds, okay. Let's get a settler out. Thank you. I think I'll build a city here. And I'll cover this area here. Or just some silver down here. Huh. Some couple of silvers down here. If I build the city here instead, one, two, yeah, maybe here or right on here. Is this okay? This is next river, so I can build a water mill. I can grab all of this, I think. Including the sheep, which the Washington can also get. Let me heal you up. I know you're low on housing, working on that. Oh, yes, this is the Chinese wonder, the Great Wall. Instead of a wonder, you actually build, well, not really a wonder in this game, but the Chinese ability. You can actually build sections of the Great Wall on the map itself. And it's actually an actual barrier. It's not a wonder you build, per se. Increased growth all cities, Mr. River. That Hanging Gardens is kind of tempting because it's not a great one, but anything that boosts growth is, if this is anything like Civ 5, it's good. No, I don't want you to inspect my territory. No, thank you.
We can no more have exact religious thinking without theology than exact mensuration and astronomy without mathematics.
Okay, yeah, I wanted to do a build there here. Let me find a city-state. I hope I didn't accidentally turn off city-states, but I don't think I did. Okay. fortify here. No, I'm not gonna play nice with you, Brazil. You annoy me. Okay, let's get a market up. Whoa, barbarian battering rams. So I'm kind of middle of the road here, in terms of power.
We are all apprentices in a craft where no one ever becomes a master.
Rush by anything? Get a Oh, I can. Okay, good. Let's rush by a trader. And then I'm going to switch my production to a builder instead. Because I have a lot of money sitting there doing nothing. Okay, this is to go here first. I want to build an encampment. I want to build it in a strategic area, which will be here. So let me buy this tile first. Can I purchase the tile? No. Do this first. Go build encampment. Let's send it to St. Louis. Get our roads going. We're down 2 amenities, okay. We need more amenities. Marco Polo. Why not?
A great merchant has come to our civilization. Each one has a unique talent, which will help our economy flourish.
Okay, so what can I do with this guy? Oh, do I have to move him to the trading post?
Os seus melhores engenheiros e arquitetos seriam mais felizes em um lugar onde pudessem crescer. No Brasil, por exemplo.
Yeah, they're just shit talking me. Do I need to move? Okay. He's here. Yeah, I have to use him here. Grants a free trader unit to the city and increases trade route. Introduces. Okay, I'm good with that. Okay, let's send him to China. Okay.
Organisms don't think of CO2 as a poison. Plants and organisms that make shells, coral, think of it as a building block.
Oh, great one. Our natural wonder. Still no city-states, though. Okay. Right, so... let's buy another tile here. Actually, I'm gonna get these dyes first. Oh, didn't even notice the barbarians lurking in the shadows. Oh, I'm in a city state finally. Yay!
Without mathematics, there's nothing you can do.
That's very
Everything
true.
Everything around you is mathematics. Everything around you is numbers.
Oh my god, finally found a city state. Jesus. What's the quest they're giving me? Recruit a great writer. Well, great. I'm gonna finally send my envoy. So in this game, you earn envoys each turn, or earn points towards an envoy each turn. And so instead of dumping money, you dump envoys. Oh, I can send 4. Well, send them all in, I think. How much control do I have? Yeah, but it counts as 5 because one of the first envoys I sent counts as 2, so I'm tier 2. Getting more production, which is good. Going, I can build universities.
Wu fan gua ren, gua ren zhi qing, tian xia mo zhi yu kang.
They're just very happy that we're not building wonders against them. Okay, so I think this is a good place to end our episode after this animation finishes up. We'll pick up next time. Do one more thing. There we go. Alright, I'll pick up next time. We actually found a city state here. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you next time.